Fine book. We are students of class 5 Rigel, and our topic is Pretty with a Purpose. So let's start with a big question. What effect can my actions have on the reproduction of plants? So let's discover. Over to you, Pep.
I'm Prushika and I'm Pep. I will help you brainstorm to get an insight on this topic and also help you use the knowledge gained in previous classes. In 30 seconds, write down 3 adjectives when you hear the word flower. Time's up. So, the answers must be beautiful, fragrant, colorful, pretty, etc. Now, look at this picture and help the bee and the moth to reach the flower. Wonderful, we did it. Do you think the insects wanted to visit the flower or vice versa? Well, yes, because the sweet nectar is a source of energy for them and accidentally they help in the transfer of pollen grains. Yippee, what a classic example of interdependence. What do you think and ink?
I'm Arun and I'm thinking ink. Now, let's listen to a conversation between Molly and her father. Thank you for this delicious apple, Pa.
You're welcome, Molly. Do you know that the seed in this apple can grow into a whole new apple tree?
Yes, the seeds in the fruit can grow into a whole new apple tree.
Do you know about it?
Of course.
Why don't you tell me?
Life cycle of an apple tree. Flowers bloom on fully grown apple trees. They undergo a process called pollination, where the pollen is transferred from the stamen to the carpel. Fertilization occurs as the pollen joins with the ovules. The fertilized ovules develop into seeds and the ovary develops into the fruit. This fruit contains many seeds which can make many more trees. Flowers contain the reproductive parts of a flowering plant. Now, over to you, Pep.
I'm Yashishwini and I am Pam. Let's sing a rhyme and then brainstorm a little more. A little plum, pretty plum, what do I need? Need your help to make a seed. My little seeds make more of me. Lots of plants for the ears to be. It's time to think and write 3 ways in which plants and animals help plant and plants help animals. Plants give food, shelter and shade, whereas animals help plants in pollination, provide carbon dioxide for photosynthesis. And did you know animals extract that act as good source of manure to the plants? Thanks. Over to you, Lukwidin.
I am Pratik and I am Lukwidin. I will help you think deeper. Plants and animals benefit from each other during the processes of pollination and seed dispersal. Recall an incident in your own life when someone you have helped in the past has helped you back or vice versa. So, once my friend forgot to get his pencil box during the exam, so I gave him a pencil. He was very happy and thankful. In science examination, I forgot to carry pencil colors, so my friend shared it with me. And that's how we helped each other. Now over to you, Think and Ink.
I'm thinking ink. Let's conclude the big question after inking question 1. Charlie's uncle wanted more pollinators to visit their house. What needs to be done in order to attract more pollinators? Well, he can grow more attractive flowers, raise bees, and use less amount of insect repellent spray to attract more pollinators. Question 2. After a few weeks, Charlie noticed many insects in their house. And her uncle prevents her from using insect repellent spray. She wonders why. Her uncle tells her that using the spray will kill insects who are pollinators, and fewer pollinators mean less number of fruits. Therefore, we can conclude the big question by saying that plants and animals are dependent on each other. Plants are dependent on animals, such as bees, bats, moths, and butterflies for the process of pollination, which is the first step in the process of reproduction. Hope we should not harm animals as we need them for our continuous supply of food from plants. Hope the session was interesting. Please give your valuable feedback and give us 5 stars. Thank you. Bye from all of us.
Bye. Bye. Bye.